must be losing the effect of the sedative about now. And you must be wondering what the hell you've gotten yourself into.
Hello, Chris Watkins, Death.
Chris, did John go to work early with you today?
No, I haven't seen him since he left yesterday. What's wrong?
Chris, I'll call you back.
Sam, wait.
I'm not gonna lie to you. I brought you here to kill you. Well, no, not exactly. Your death will be the inevitable result of what I'll be doing here. And I'm quite good at what I do, my good man. Half the enjoyment is telling you what I'm going to do beforehand, so that you cry and moan at what's about to happen. So to begin, I'm going to torture you. I'm going to torture you until you're nothing but a shell of a man. And then, because it's the humane thing to do, I'm going to kill you. I'm going to put you out of your misery. See, you have no hope. You are, in fact, already dead. Your heart is still beating, but you've got no chance to survive this. No chance for escape. You are completely and utterly dead. Enough talk. Let's begin, shall we?
Sorry, ma'am, but a person has to be missing for more than 24 hours before we can do anything about it.
Please, there must be something you can do.
At this point, the most we can do is take a description and keep a lookout for him, but other than...
Here, I have a picture.
Okay, was he driving any sort of car or truck when you last saw him?
Yeah, a yellow sports car. License number? AR-151, I think.
Okay, we'll keep a lookout for him, but I can't guarantee anything. If you want, you can wait here for a while, but it might be a long wait.
John? Is that you?
Help. I'm trapped in a house on Reed Road.
John? What's wrong?
You have to help me. Please come.
What are you doing?
John? John!
I told you, but you wouldn't listen. You're not supposed to try and escape. You're supposed to be submissive. Now I must remind you exactly how unavoidable your fate is.
John? What are you doing here? What's going on? Why didn't you come home? Why didn't you call? John, answer me.
Sam, Sam,